Hello everyone and welcome back to my playlist of pathology. We are doing this from medium robins to put things in context. Restrictive lung disorders humne start kiya hai and I told you there are four categories. Meri previous video dekhiyega jisme maine introduction diya hai about the restrictive lung disorders. And the four categories mein se jo pehli category hai, that is the fibrosing category of restrictive lung disorder. And today we are starting the fibrosing category. Obviously, in this category, as the name indicate, there will be lung fibrosis. And the first pathology that we have to cover is known as idiopathic pulmonary fibrosis. Now, as the name indicate, idiopathic, it basically means ke the cause is exactly not known, right? It refers to a pulmonary disorders of unknown etiology, and that is why it is given the name idiopathic. That is characterized by patchy, progressive, bilateral, interstitial fibrosis. So the hallmark at the end of the day would be the fibrosis in both the lungs. It is bilateral fibrosis and it is progressive, right? Yani waqt ke saath saath ye mazid badhegi. Because its etiology is unknown, it is also known as cryptogenic fibrosing alveolitis. So cryptogenic fibrosing alveolitis basically indicates that there is involvement of alveoli, there is inflammatory component, and it is progressive. Males are usually affected more as compared to the females, and it is the disease of aging as you age. And technically, I mean, there will be very, very few cases under the age of 50. So virtually never occurring before the age of 50. The radiologic and the histologic pattern of fibrosis is referred to as usual interstitial pneumonia. Ye sare naam aapko pata hone chahiye ki idiopathic pulmonary fibrosis can also be named as UIP. It can also be named as cryptogenic fibrosing alveolitis. ये सारे नाम एग्जाम में आपको टेस्ट किए जा सकते हैं. ऑफ नोट, सिमिलर पैथोलॉजिक चेंजेस इन द लंग मे बी प्रेजेंट इन एंटिटीज सच एज एस्बेस्टोसिस, कोलेजन वैस्कुलर डिजीज एंड अदर कंडीशन. देयरफॉर आईपीएफ इज एक्चुअली द डायग्नोसिस ऑफ एक्सक्लूजन. देखें, तमाम ही रिस्ट्रिक्टिव लंग डिसऑर्डर्स में एक इशू ये है कि मैनी ओवरलैपिंग फीचर्स आर प्रेजेंट. और पर्टिकुलरली अगर आप इडियोपैथिक पल्मोनरी फाइब्रोसिस की बात कर रहे हैं तो यू हैव टू रूल आउट अ लॉट ऑफ डिजीजेस. यू हैव टू मेक श्योर दैट द पेशेंट डज नॉट हैव एस्बेस्टोसिस फॉर एग्जाम्पल, द पेशेंट डज नॉट हैव कोलेजन वैस्कुलर डिजीजेस. इनके लिए कुछ ऑब्जेक्टिव टेस्टिंग है, इसमें हिस्ट्री होगी, इसमें कोई ना कोई आप स्कैनिंग करेंगे, तो आपको बाकी डिजीजेस को रूल आउट करना है, तभी आप लेबल कर सकते हो कि दिस इज आईपीएफ, राइट? सिर्फ फाइब्रोसिस देख के आईपीएफ नहीं बोल देंगे. पैथोजेनेसिस आपको बतानी चाहिए हर डिजीज की, बिकॉज वी आर स्टडिंग पैथोलॉजी. सो इंटरस्टिशियल फाइब्रोसिस दैट कैरेक्टराइजेस आईपीएफ, व्हिच इज इडियोपैथिक पल्मोनरी फाइब्रोसिस, इट इज बिलीव टू रिजल्ट फ्रॉम रिपीटेड इंजरी एंड डिफेक्टिव रिपेयर ऑफ द एल्वुलर एपिथेलियम. सो अगर बार बार एल्वुलर इंजरी हो और वो रिपेयर ठीक से ना हो, और ये यूजुअली जेनेटिकली प्रीडिस्पोज लोगों में होती है. द कॉज ऑफ इंजरी इज अननोन, देयरफॉर इट इज इडियोपैथिक. एंड अ वैरायटी ऑफ सोर्सेज हैव बीन प्रपोज्ड, इंक्लूडिंग इवन द गैस्ट्रोइसोफेजियल रिफ्लक्स. सो एग्जैक्ट कॉज तो बेसिकली पता नहीं है. हाउ एवर, ओनली अ स्मॉल फ्रैक्शन ऑफ इंडिविजुअल सफरिंग फ्रॉम रिफ्लक्स और एक्सपोज टू अदर प्रपोज इन्वायरमेंटल ट्रिगर्स डेवलप आईपीएफ. सब वेग है क्योंकि कुछ एग्जैक्ट पता नहीं है. पता चल जाए तो ये एडियोपैथिक नहीं बचे ना, है ना? सो द क्लियरेस्ट इटियोलॉजिक क्ल्यूज कम फ्रॉम जेनेरिक स्टडीज. यानी उन लोगों को स्टडी किया गया जिनमें इडियोपैथिक पल्मोनरी फाइब्रोसिस है, एंड देन दे ट्रेस्ड इट बैक टू सम जेनेटिक एसोसिएशन. सो जर्म लाइन म्यूटेशन लीडिंग टू लॉस ऑफ टेलोमेरेज आर एसोसिएटेड विद इंक्रीज रिस्क ऑफ आईपीएफ, सजेस्टिंग के एजिंग, बिकॉज टेलोमेरेज आपको पता है कि दे आर डायरेक्टली एसोसिएटेड विद सेलुलर सेनेसेंस एजिंग, राइट? द लिंक टू सेलुलर एजिंग ऑल्सो इज इन लाइन विद द ऑब्जर्वेशन दैट आईपीएफ इज अ डिसऑर्डर ऑफ ओल्डर एडल्ट. जैसे जैसे एजिंग हो रही है, टेलोमेरेज एक्टिविटी अफेक्ट होगी, इसीलिए ओल्डर एजेंट्स में ये डिजीज आपको, पेशेंट्स में ये डिजीज आपको देखने को मिलती है, वर्चुअली नेवर बिफोर द एज ऑफ 50, राइट? Okay. Other genetic associations also point to the primary defect residing in epithelial cells. Specifically, 35% of the affected individuals have a genetic mutation is MUC5B gene that alters the production of mucin, while a smaller number. So these are all proposed mechanisms ke bhai mucin gene ek hai, MUC5B usme mutation ho sakti hai to ye disease ho sakti hai, telomerase mein functional abnormality hai to ye disease ho sakti hai. These type of mutations and genetic variation conditions have been associated with development of IPF. IPF ki exact cause hame nahi pata, right? These genes are only expressed in lung epithelial cells, indicating the epithelial abnormality can be primary initiator for these. So these are all hypotheses based, okay? Although the mechanism of fibrosis are incompletely understood, there are recent data which points toward excessive activation of pro-fibrotic factor वो factor होंगे जो fibrosis करवाएंगे, anti-fibrotic वो होंगे जो fibrosis को रोकेंगे. TGF-beta is a pro-fibrotic factor, okay? So clinically, how do these patients present? These patients usually have complaints of gradual onset of cough, which is non-productive. Productive होगी तो फिर आप सोचेंगे about infection. And there is progressive dyspnea. On physical examination, most patients have dry or Velcro-like crackles also on the inspiration. Cyanosis may be there, core pulmonary, respiratory failure, depending upon degree of fibrosis kya hai. The characteristic clinical and radiographic finding, subpleural and basilar fibrosis. Fibrosis will be there, obviously. This is the fibrotic disorder. Anti-inflammatory therapies have proven to be of little use. By contrast, anti-fibrotic therapies, such as inhibition of TGF-beta and tyrosine kinase inhibitors, they have been found useful. The overall prognosis actually remains poor, and this is a dangerous disease. I mean, it's a high mortality rate. Survival is only 3-5 in a full-blown IPF patient, right? And lung transplantation is the only definitive treatment. So that's kind of a very nasty disease. Once it happens, it's bad. And now this algorithm shows you the proposed genetic and the environmental factors which are causing the pathogenesis of the disease. So there are some environmental factors, then obviously there are genetic factors, telomerase and MUC5B mutations, and these are the epithelial cells obviously. And in factors ki wajah se, if there is persistent epithelial injury, what happens that there is increased pro-fibrotic factors released, such as TGF-beta. And that then leads to collagen production and ultimately fibrosis. So this is the proposed mechanism for development of IPF. However, exact environmental factors are not known, and exact genetic mutations are not known. Very little is known, but that is a proposed mechanism. Okay, so that's all about the IPF. Next time, we start getting pneumoconiosis. Take care of yourself.